brought over from Dixiana, Virginia.
Huh.
And I worked in four or five different railroads on the East Coast when it was built from 1912 until about the 1950s. Pennsylvania, Virginia, West Virginia, Tennessee.
Jeez.
Worked in like several coal mining outfits, a couple of logging mines out there in the East. Then it was retired. It's scrapped and just forgotten about, set aside for years, just collecting rust. Lima, Ohio.
Huh.
The Lima Locomotive Machine Shop.
Huh.
Now these are pretty, these geared locomotives are pretty rare.
Thank you. almost three stories of difference. And that's an 8.5% grade for you. Just look at the angle that these redwood trees are growing in conjunction to your rail car. You'll see how steep this hill really is. Hear the engine working real hard? While you're listening to that, please take a moment to get your tickets out. Your reservations. Anything you have that shows you want a ticket to ride this train today. Get that out. I'm going to start collecting your tickets. I can't touch them. They don't want to spread germs on them. Have them unfolded, out and ready, and I'll be right with you to check your tickets or keep you off the train.
Thank you.
marsupial here on this piece of property. I'm talking about those humble, happy opossums. Yes, opossums. Now, before you go, ew, opossums, hear me out here. They're actually pretty amazing little critters. Because of their lower body temperature, it's nearly impossible for them to contract rabies. They also eat fleas and ticks. So if you don't like fleas, ticks, or rabies, which you shouldn't, then maybe you should be a little nicer to North America's only marsupial, the opossums. Now we also have bobcats, tomcats, mountain lions, mountain cougars, deer, coyote, banana slugs, and if you look really carefully through the trees around us, not to be confused with the hairy man of Santa Cruz County, you may spot yourself a Sasquatch. We're talking about Bigfoot, he's out here too. Now once we get rolling, if you're on the right-hand side of this train, you're going to want to look at that hillside, anywhere you see little crevices. What you're looking for is banana slugs. They like to burrow when it gets a little drier, like it is this afternoon. So look at all those little crevices, you might catch a glimpse of the banana slugs and take them out. That's if you're on the right-hand side of this train. But if you're on the left-hand side of this train, you should look down the hillside you just came up, because if you do, you're going to have a quick overview of the whole switchback system and the burned-down trestle from above. And don't worry, right-hand side, you'll be able to see all this stuff when we come down the mountain a little bit once this train turns around. We'll be facing the opposite direction. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the views, ladies and gentlemen. That's all you've got to do. Now back to the trees, right? Redwood trees in this valley, above the ground, can live for 2,200 years. But below the ground, the roots on these trees can live for 10,000 years. Making those roots the oldest living things on planet Earth. Now once the tree top gets to a mature age of 2,200 years old, it's going to fall over and die. Behind a stump with the roots attached still alive. Those roots will get right back to work regrowing another tree by sending up a circle of sprouts around the original stump. These sprouts will eventually form full-sized redwood trees in a very small circle of a cluster known as a cathedral grove. After another 2,200 years, this first small grove will fall over just like that first tree originally did. Once again, those roots will send up another circle of sprouts on the outside of that first small circle, making a slightly larger cathedral grove. This keeps repeating for 10,000 years until those roots die. But after 9,000 years, you're eventually left with a massive cathedral grove large enough to host a wedding, just like we got on top of Bear Mountain, couldn't you see in a little bit? This is actually how redwood trees reproduce about 85% of the time through their roots. But you've got to be careful. When they reproduce this way, they're actually producing genetic copies of each other. Meaning, all those trees in the circles have the exact same DNA. Meaning, that if all the trees in this whole forest reproduce through their roots alone, all it would take is one disease to knock out this whole forest, which is kind of bad. For a health grade genetic biodiversity, these trees grow from seeds.
Danger.
America once again. And this time, the right-hand side of the train is going to have the opportunity to get a video, just like the left-hand side had the opportunity to do so earlier. Just please remain seated for the rest of this trip, but in particular, on the bridge. The bridge is 210 feet long and 42 feet tall. And guess what? It's kind of difficult to stick the landing from 42 feet in the air. Thank you. listening to the special threshold. Remember that party piece of information on the off party is here. Doug on that whistle. Your fireman Tommy on the bell slow down and connect to Charlie on the annoying voice that might present all the interns. Come on down and support our railroad. Hope you all enjoyed this trip today.